Philippine shares managed to snap out of a 150-point two-day losing streak on Tuesday to climb 1% or 66 points, though still below the 6,600 level. Net foreign buying was at 30.8 million pesos, and actually we already have the opening numbers in the green again, up by a quarter of 1%, 16.6604. Joining us this morning to talk shop is Joey Rojas of Eagle Equities. Hi, Joey. Good to see you.
Hello. Good morning, Mimi.
Good morning. The market is up. It looks like investors are positioning for the Banco Central's policy meeting that's happening tomorrow after trading hours. What's your bet?
You know, really, over the last few weeks, what has been keeping the market down is the so many holidays that come right after the other. So when people are on vacation, they tend to hold back on their market activities. But now, since that's over, and maybe the next holiday will be June 12 already, that's quite crazy. You know, that's a little further away. People are becoming more active again. Secondly, there's a lot. Most of the first quarter reports are in, and they're all very, very good. Last year's first quarter was still so-so because we're just getting out of the pandemic. But now that we're fully back to normal, it seems that businesses are generating revenues that are even higher than pre-pandemic.
All right. So you think this could propel the PSEI to 6,700?
Well, of course, 67 is the first, 66 first, no, and then 67. Then, yeah, we could, because it's the blue chips that are generating huge Q1 incomes, and it will probably continue.
All right. Just very quickly, I also wanted to get your take on some interesting corporate stories that we had this morning. First Gen, of course, saying that one of its wholly owned units, Fresh River Lakes, is the highest bidder for a Kasiknan hydropower plant that's being privatized by PISAM. First Gen, how attractive are the renewables names at this point? It's not just First Gen, ASEN as well, SPNEC.
Well, definitely the space still has a lot of room to grow, not renewable energy, because renewable energy has a first deployment status. That means that you put up a renewable energy plant, you're sure that you're going to be one of the first to be deployed. compared to other types of energy power production. So that's good. At least you're sure of your demand. There will never be overbuilt renewable power plants.
Okay. All right. So you like the renewable space. What about Empedador? This morning, reporting they're doing a 7 billion peso capex for this year, and they're going to be focusing on growth abroad. It's that trend seems to be highlighted. It's not just Empedador that's focusing on international growth. Jollibee as well is looking, while they say they're not yet saturated in the local market, they're actually going to be focusing on growing abroad, international. What does that say about this market?
For these two companies, I think the problem is it's not really a problem, but you know, they are already number one in their specific industries. So it's hard to, for me, if you're already number one and you're on everybody's table or in everybody's mind when there's a party, when there's, oh, let's go out to eat mindset, I think it's hard to grow more. Your growth will probably come with population growth na lang. Our population is not slowing down either, no? But still, if your local market is already mostly fully provided for, there's no choice but to go abroad. And let's say for Emperador, India is a huge population. They can get in there. and get popular there, I think you might not have enough grapes in Spain to.
All right. Just very quickly, the IPO is in the pipeline. We've got one, Repower. How attractive is Repower? It's Red Sea, I think. It's going to be a ticker symbol of Red Sea. How attractive are the names in the IPO pipeline? And do you think the timing is good?
Well, Red Sea is number one in renewable energy, which I like the space. Number two, the offering price is not high. Mm-hmm. It looks high because maximum is 5 pesos. And you can see SPNEC at 1 peso 50. You can see Alter at 90 something cents. Mm-hmm. But remember, these two companies, the par value is 10 cents. Mm-hmm. For Alter at 90 cents, that's like saying Red Sea at 9 pesos.
Mm-hmm.
No? SPNEC is like 15 or 14 pesos if you bring the par up to 1 peso.
Mm-hmm.
So they are not really comparable.
Okay.
So at for Red Sea at 5 pesos, that's like selling it at 50 cents. If you're just looking at the price. Huh? Aside from that, I think they said in their briefing that they will probably make about 300 million this year, which is about 10 times PE, which is not bad at all, because there's still the proceeds they will continue to the proceeds of the IPO will be used to continue to build the company. By the way, I have to make a disclaimer. I am related to the president of the company.
All right. Thank you so much for that disclaimer, for being very transparent. Joey, I think you accidentally turned off your camera. No problem, because we're at the end already. Mm-hmm. The blind item. So why don't you tell us about the stock that you're monitoring closely? Don't tell us. Just describe. So what do you have for us today? Why do you like this stock?
Okay. This company is one. Oh, my video's back. This company is one of the really big turnaround stories for 2022.
Mm-hmm.
Up to the middle of last year, first half of last year, they were still in the red by about 250 million pesos.
Mm-hmm.
By the end of the year, they had net income finally of 2022 of 600 plus million pesos already.
Mm-hmm.
So they were able to recover their 250 and make another 600.
Mm-hmm.
Quarter one this year, they just announced a net income of 400 million compared to last year's loss of 220. Mm-hmm. So that brings the PE ratio to around 5. Now, you look at the chart and it has gone up quite a bit. And it made its high in sometime in October last year.
Mm-hmm.
And since then, it has been trading in a large range, but the range has been narrowing. Now, with the data coming out, I think it should move, the prices should move to a higher level soon.
All right. We're looking forward to that. But first, we're going to have to guess which stock it is. Joey, always a pleasure speaking with you. Thank you so much for joining us. Good to see you, sir.
Thank you, Mimi. See you again next time.